With the intro of the day, now we start. This is about GlobalX, anonymous whistleblowing framework. I'm Claudio Agostin. Oh, okay. Who we are? I'm speaking on behalf of the Hermes Center for Transparency and Digital Human Rights. It's our organization. We have created the HEAT for a receive a fund in order to develop GlobalX and in order to advocate about anonymity and digital human rights protection. We are also the developer of TortoWeb. TortoWeb is the proxies, the software of the proxies, used to enable users without Tor to reach the Tor darknet. I believe that someone of you know what is it. Anyway, will be discussed in the panel. We speak about whistleblowing technology because, well, in those years, a lot of dirty stuff are only has not approved in a physical, in a concrete world. Just they are approved in the documents and on the data. Therefore, empower the people to make this document camerize in order to show wrongdoings and corruption and other stuff is important. That's one of the goals of Hermes and. Is one of the meanings why whistleblowing is so important in this year and why for someone make a war against whistleblower is in their political agenda. And also digital anonymity, because if you don't stay in a place where you are between peer and you are in a minority, in a part of a minority, you can have some kind of concern to express yourself because you can fear about retaliation. You can feel about being threatened, or you can have some kind of behavior in response. You can lose your job, or being threatened, like Guido Strack yesterday explained how he get some difficulties in being a whistleblower. Therefore, anonymity help if someone wants to speak in the public interest, but has the fear to expose himself directly. GlobalX is the name of our software. It's just a software in this case. It's not a services. It's not a platform. What we do not make with GlobalX is here at Planet. This is important because usually GlobalX is mistaken with a sort of the new WikiLeaks. No, it's not at all. Because after WikiLeaks Cablegate, we figured out two important limits inside of WikiLeaks architecture. The first one was that was a central entity with a lot of responsibility of handling extremely sensitive document, the responsibility of choose what can be published and what can be not, and this kind of responsibility has bring Julian Assange confined in an embassy for years, and the other person threatened, like recently the document released by Snowden show how NSA and GHQ as a tracked every person that was related on WikiLeaks in order to fight them. And this kind of centralization mean also, if you centralize too much power, information, importance in a single entity, the power of the enemy that want to fight against this organization should be much more. Therefore, distribution, decentralization is the architectural answer. And the other things is that WikiLeaks was extremely, well, was single purpose in a certain way, because mostly was for an English speaker person, was a single organization that received documents from the whole world, but to understand something related on the Frankfurt local politics or something related to Britain in a Balkan area language, this required not a central organization, this required a person able to understand the context, the language, and the historical events of that environment. Therefore, also the distribution and the geolocalization was an important thing in order to enable what is the local whistleblowing. Because in every city can exist whistleblowing, in every city can exist something that they need to be exposed, and being able to contextualize whistleblowing initiative is important in order to attract very specific content. instead just attract something that was word related, like Iraq file or Afghanistan files and so on. Who want to be whistleblower? Well, everyone that want to break the silence know that something is wrong, but has not the vision to understand how can be exposed, how can be explained, and neither how can find someone willing to listen to a whistleblower. So the whistleblower are potential a lot of person, just that they need to know that someone is waiting for them. Corruption is one of the most typical things associated with whistleblowing, because corruption is a threat for an entire society, and the person who see and perceive the corruption happening usually don't believe that they can solve the things with the common lawful procedure, because the investigation is low, especially, I don't know, in Italy a corruption trial can work and can continue for years and bring nothing as a solution. And the corruption is just one of the typical things perceived like can be solved or can be fight with whistleblowing. Not only the corruption can be fight with whistleblowing, everything that deserves to be bring to the public vision. So the goal was helping this whistleblower with a technology can enhance the citizen and empower them with a new asset. Digital whistleblowing is then is what we are pushing. How we connect the whistleblower with the person able to understand what is going on. Usually we speak about journalists, because journalists are also the person that has the time or the knowledge or the flexibility to project himself in a specific context, study the vision or the point of vision of the whistleblower, understand the whistleblower as a very subjective vision, and contextualize their submission, their data, in a more complete point of view. So the whistleblower is someone that has something to tell, and that may also don't know that someone is interested. And the journalist is someone that can transform this raw information in something understandable by the people, in order to create a social movement and make the society aware of what is going on. If you know something, you can do something about it, is one of our slogans. But is internet safe for the whistleblower? Not at all, because we know how many kind of tracks you can leave when you are navigating, when you are collecting documents. If you are in your office, you are perhaps subject to some proxy that could track which site you are navigating into. In some states, there are censorship of a specific content, and also whistleblowing site has been censored in the past. And the whistleblower is a person that in some places is protected, like happened in a United Kingdom. In other places, a whistleblower has no rights or is not protected and is not recognized as a figure. Our project then is create a free software flexible and usable by different environments. The environment is interesting in creative whistleblowing initiative are almost free. Investigative journalists, public administration and public companies for corporate transparency, and activism and local political group. We call ourselves a framework because different countries, different law, different context, different usage, different adopters mean that different features are required. Create a framework means that we can afford the world needs without creating different software. Every topic may have an appropriate whistleblowing site, and every topic is what we call a context in the GlobalX point of view. So, an example, if Frankfurt Leaks will be created tomorrow, can have two contexts. One is bankers and their secrets, and the receiver associated to bankers and secrets context can be some journalist expert in finance and on banking lobby and so on. Other context shall be environmental pollution, and the receiver of associated to that context can be the local Greenpeace organization, can be some journalist dedicated to the environment, and so on. Role separation is one of the key things in Global Leaks, because always in order to separate the responsibility, who is creating the initiative, who is running the Global Leaks node, is called node administrator, the person that is creating the initiative. And the person who is creating the initiative is just the person with the political view or the editorial view, editorial vision, that understand that an initiative can be useful and can be used. The receiver are the person who are subscribed, who are registered on the whistleblowing site, and they actually receive the documents. They analyze the document, understand what has been submitted. And the whistleblower is the person who anonymously connected himself to the whistleblowing initiative and send the documents, describe the documents that he's sending in order to make the flow working. So the goal was to change this paradigm of the missing of the whistleblower, or just to go over of the previously system used to spot hidden things that commonly I'm someone who go to a journalist and report something using my cell phone, being tracked, collecting documents in a non-safe way, and the journalist know me, can turn on me, and so on. Because online, some kind of psychological barrier are decreased. Some person feel comfortable being online because know that he's managing some documents that can contains dirty things. He can understand that some technology are safe and will not track them, and then in a more safe way can export a lot of documents, a lot of giga megabytes of data, and those data can receive in a safe way a journalist. That's what is an ANSI technology for whistleblowing. But needed to be respected a strong level of privacy and of security, because otherwise the tracks that you left can block your anonymity and your protection. Especially with the fact that the amount of tracking system and the monitoring system online are really, really deep and present. But not every node needs to be NSA proof, because if you are working for a local whistleblowing organization, your enemy is not the NSA. So as first, we need to understand that when is planning the security of a node, it's important to understand who is the potential enemy and to figure out which is the best compromise in order to reach the most possible amount of whistleblower without giving too many limits. Using Tor to reach anonymously a website, it gives one of the most higher level of security, but also is a requirement that can decrease the amount of potential whistleblower. This kind of analysis need to be made by the node maintainer, because he need to figure out which is the potential danger for the whistleblower. At the moment, we support already 10 different languages in the distributed package, and this is the meanings of the fact that it can adapt it on different environment, and different law or threat to a whistleblower can easily be understood, planned, and the countermeasure can be selected by the node maintainer. Usually, before a whistleblowing safe platform, the person use email, web browsing, phone call, location tracking, metadata, and data retention happen to him. Therefore, what is important when a whistleblower initiative is created is that if the whistleblower starts to interact with a journalist in a safe way, it's better if this this way is continually used, not that how is it happen in sometimes when a whistleblower starts to interact with a journalist in an anonymous way, the journalist asks to the whistleblower, okay, give me your phone number and we can meet at the bar and then we can talk safely. No, what is important is continue to use a safe environment where both are protected. So, connection protection is guaranteed to Tor because every installation of GlobalLeaks exposes himself to Tor Hidden Services. Tor Hidden Services is a system to being reachable in the dark net without disclosing the physical location of the server and without disclosing the IP address of the server. And that every time someone reaches the GlobalLeaks node, their tracks are deleted, are anonymized by the Tor network. Therefore, does not exist the possibility to keep track of the IP address connected to a GlobalX node because it's only reachable through Tor. This also guarantees protection from censorship because if you stay in the darknet, you cannot be censored. And of course, does not disclose the physical location. There are a lot of security, flexibility, and potentiality in a GlobalLeaks configuration. The first part of the screenshot is from the bottom of the main page of GlobalLeaks website, globalx.org. There are some links that explain in a very deeply way the threat model we analyzed and we managed to protect too. The application security, some operating security hint for the system administrator who is running a GlobalX initiative, and some security advice for the whistleblower. Anyway, the important points for the security of the system are that can be configured if want to be received only anonymous connection, so only connection using Tor can be accepted, or also connection received to Tor to web. Tor to web is this kind of proxies that permit to a person without Tor to reach a Tor hidden services. Without Tor to web, it's impossible otherwise to reach the darknet content. At the moment, what is interesting that is that you know a network is important. Is measured the importance on the square of their nodes. So, more a network is large, more is important because is more easier to find someone in this network. One of the issues of the darknet is that only who are using the darknet know the darknet content, and this has created the a limit on the darknet growing, also a misconception of the fact that the darknet contain only illegal sites and bad material and so on. What with Tor to web is possible is to show to the world internet that the darknet contain also important content and content that otherwise can be censored or can be threatening for the person who is running the server. And can be configured a GlobalX node in order to show which are the contexts that is managed, but do not accept not anonymous connection, not anonymous submission. Therefore, the whistleblower is always safe, and the whistleblower can get to start to know about a whistleblower initiative, a GlobalX node, using Tor to web, an example. For the encryption, everything that transit on GlobalX is encrypted. From the first upload, the data that are received are encrypted on an ephemeral key and stored on the disk until with a synchronous process, encrypted for the PGP keys of the various journalists the content. Potentially, one node can also run without using PGP, depends on the security level that the node administration decided to support. We have got already three professional security review, penetration test that has verified our design and our code source, code base. Our data retention policies is that everything that is submitted on Global Leaks stay on a safe area. In this safe area, the whistleblower can interact for sometimes with the journalist. The journalist can comment back to the whistleblower in order to exchange comments about the documents submitted. The whistleblower can upload the new documents if the receiver asks for something new. This can help to understand something that typically is very contextualized, like the document leaked, to a more comprehensible way for the journalists that need to understand the big picture and the world vision of the element. And after a certain amount of time, when the tip, the submission expire, the whole data, files, comments, and elements, metadata that describe the files, they're all whipped out in an automatical way. This kind of data retention policy causes that if something important is published because someone has leaked, also if someone starts an investigation or try to steal the server or to seize the server, the document, the submission, will be very likely already deleted because it's not important to collect sensitive data for a limited amount of time. And this keeps the server clean. In addition, we have a continuously awareness hint and message for the whistleblower in order to explain to him or to she if is anonymous, if it's not, which are the danger, how can handle safety the document is working on, etc. Running a Global Leaks node has some troubles for the node administrator, and that are the trouble dependent or the fact that a whistleblowing initiative is not just a software that is running. A whistleblowing initiative is a large scale vision promoted by someone who understands that transparency is important and how can be reached. So social activism by solidity whistleblower is not just running a node and a Twitter account. Need to figure out how those whistleblowers can be reached and how can be contacted and stimulated to leak out documents. There are different goals and methods, and therefore the flexibility provided by the software is intended to cover those various goals and method because it's not just one or two usage possible. And usually the activist lack of the skills required to create a whistleblowing initiative. Those kinds of initiatives are very well deployed by someone expert in communication, like an editor that understand how the things need to be validated, verified, and how the news needs to be written and how it needs to be disclosed. Also, if you take in mind the most important release of WikiLeaks was not released because someone has leaked out the document and the document is was important itself. The most important release was intermediated by journalists who understand the value of the leaked document, understand the history behind, and make it comprehensible for the end user. And another administrator has some responsibility that need to be continuously challenged. Someone of those responsibilities are important at the start of an initiative and once a while need to be reviewed, and some other instead are always present. They need to be analyzed in a dedicated way. Infrastructure mean how in fact the node will be run. If beside the node also a blog site or a journal need to be used to report the stories received and to promote the whistleblowing, where the physical server stay is important to be planned because different states have different law. and who is gonna to manage those server need to be selected. The aspect of security need to be studied because different whistleblowing initiative trigger different different answer from the person who want to protect the secrecy of the documents, and therefore this kind of concern need to be raised before start an initiative. If I'm planning to create, I will never plan to create an initiative because I'm one of the software developers, and for the rule of splitting the responsibility, we never create initiative. Anyway, we provide support for who is running initiative, and we answer to their question. So if someone is creating an initiative for helps investigative journalism in a Western country, there are some kind of security elements that can be considered, but it's very different if someone other is creating an initiative called Mafia Leaks that want to help, let's say, the child of the bosses that want to block the mafia families. And those kind of considerations need to be done when the initiative starts. Software and procedure is important because when a receiver, that can be a lawyer, a journalist, a group of those person and so on, receive a document, they need to keep track of their effort, they need to validate the documents, and there are some kind of support system. An example, Document Cloud can be used to provide the collaborative review, or other kind of integration has been used and tested in order to help a collaborative review of the leaked documents in a protected way. And the legal aspect, because there are some places where whistleblowing solicit is partially illegal. An example in Japan, promote and asks to leaks document is illegal. In other places, you can ask for something that won't to be transparent, but you can't ask to someone to go against the law. And if someone probably has seen that he will never reveal the secrets of their working environment, and you asking to him to reveal that secret, you are infringing the law. Therefore, this kind of analysis need to be made, and they are different from every country. And always need to be keeping attention on the editorial policies. So how, when a story is ready to be published, and how can be solicited whistleblowing with, an example, advertising on social networking, or which kind of promotion you can do in order to attract more leaks, and how can you collect funds in order to make the things where it works. And the organization is how the node maintainer select the receiver and choose a new person that are expert and trustable enough to receive a not yet released document that need to be reviewed and understand. The responsibility of the receiver instead are of trust only the data, because what is commonly perceived is that a submission is made by, I've seen something, I brought a few lines, and I just give this secret and this tip off to the journalist, and then the journalist make the news. No, this is not a news. This is just a gossip. What is important for a journalist is receive the document and make analysis, cross-checking and validation of this content, and potentially not have the document, but have the tip on how the journalist alone can get the document or the proof of the wrongdoings. Because this is the right way to work in an investigative environment. You cannot trust what is received by anonymous whistleblower, because anonymous whistleblower can also just spread a lie or a personal belief to a journalist, and the receiver, the journalist, need to protect himself from these kind of things. They need to be knowledgeable. In example, they need to be trustworthy and well-known. they are not anonymous, so the whistleblower knows that it's leaking to a specific journalist or a specific lawyer, and can choose if trust them or do not trust them. Okay, now we take a look about the most relevant installation of GlobalX running at the moment. Those three are three kind of investigative journalism organization: IRPIX from Italia, Atlazzo from Hungary, and Perun from Serbia. They work in more or less in the same way. They are collecting documents of various categories of public interest. We can see the flow in the bottom. The whistleblower select a category, send a tip. The media verification, make the fact checking of the received document and make his journalist works. Create a story if the story in fact exists. And then coordinate among other media the press release and the release of the document. Pistachia is an anti-corruption activism, is a different model. An example, 5 minutes.
No, actually, your time is up.
I'm in the definition. In this case, when a tip received to Pistachia issue a FOIA, Freedom of Information Act, in order to receive the document from the government, and using the tip of the whistleblower and the official document received by the government, they can spot the corruption and report to the authorities the things spotted. The Jostan is a was born in from Iceland. What is interesting is Djost is born much more before the his presentation to the public. It was an underground organization that started to collect data and to attract whistleblower without going public until he had something important in the hand and was the raw data of the Iceland banking collapse. The release has been made on the 30th, and on the 31, when the crowdsourcing of the users has started to analyze the data, they discovered that there are relationships between the finance minister and the banks before the collapse, the bank collapse. Publix is a multi-stakeholder initiative, is running on Netherlands. Yes, is an organization which 42 national media are subscribed and is acting as a trusted platform for every Dutch person that wanted to speak with a journalist in a safe way. There are really all the kind of media, television or a blog or a paper. The foundation try to protect the whistleblower, also collecting money and eventually provide defense for the journalist or for the whistleblower if something is will happen. So they work as a foundation to protect the whistleblower in general. Is accessible through Tor to web, so HTTPS interfaces or through Tor, because they understand that also submit the things to Tor to web was acceptable for their threat model. This is the flow. So one whistleblower can at the best leak to free media and cannot leak to the world media, over 42. If only one media has this data as a VAHA exclusive, but this has been selected by the whistleblower, if other media receive the same data, they have a gentleman agreement between the journalist to respect an embargo. Therefore, no one can speak publicly about the information received before a certain data, because this will otherwise start a race between the journalist, and this will lead to release an unverified document. Therefore, this embargo period can permit a better quality of the news. Mafelix is an experiment run in Italy in order to expose data against related to the mafia, and it collected various kinds of data, can interact with the journalist know for anti-mafia fighting, for ONG of support for mafia witness that want to save himself, or for authorities that try to fight him. So what is the question at the end of the panel really is, what's your social activism schema and ideas? Because the environment that require transparency are really plenty. The visibility obtained by the leaking movement is still high in those years. And if someone has some idea, I and the Hermes people are able to help and to provide support. And this is the finish of the things. Can you find the project plan of the software and of the organization? It's a little updated, but it's still complete in that link. And the software is obviously open source in GitHub. Everyone can fork it. It's written in Python and JavaScript. And there are the design well documented online. Besides GlobalX that provide the software, we, Whistleblowing Everywhere, is an umbrella organization that try to help for the point before exposed, legal, security, infrastructure, and other editorials and other elements that need to be considered beside the software itself. So, thank you. No, there are no distribution between the nodes because every node is itself. So there are no communication between nodes. When a data is received, is never written in plain text on the disks because it's encrypted with an ephemeral AES keys. And after, is this document is always in memory, so never written in plain text. Decrypted from the ephemeral keys and encrypted for the PGP keys of the receiver. The receiver are the journalist. If they are a plenty receiver, has a plenty multiple encryption in order to have an encrypted document, an encrypted data for every potential receiver. Why we do not encrypt immediately in PGP? Because this otherwise can trigger a lot of CPU time and effort and load from the machine triggered by anonymous behavior, and this will lead to denial of services. Therefore, we before make an encryption in a symmetric way, and then is dispatched to the receiver. It's not dispatched in the fact that are sent, the content are collected on the node encrypted. When the receiver connected to the node, he found a new tip and downloaded the files. Usually, depends on the security design of the application, of the installation, sorry. The receiver can receive the document on their computer, or they can use Tails, the anonymous live system on a USB key, in order to work in an air-gapped server, computer, disconnected from internet, and in order to avoid potential exploiting.
Well, yeah. Point what I was planning to go to is the point is now what happens if, for example, the NSA sets up nodes, so they just simply can delete leaks from the network because they are not there in replicated form or something like that. That means they are only sent to one node and it's no concern.
Okay, you mean if someone creates a fake node?
Yeah.
Well, at the moment, every of those organizations has a public site, and they indicate which is the hidden services. So, if you know Greenpeace and you go on Greenpeace website and you find Greenpeace hidden services, you reach that GlobalX node. If someone other tell to you, hey, leak to me, I'm I'm someone who won't receive your leaks and you believed to them, we cannot solve that.
You need to build social trust. So
exactly.
If you maybe need some persons in real life that stand up and say, like, I'm from this lead platform and I advise you to lead to that address.
Exactly. So at the moment, at the moment, this is the things. But maybe it's time to give the microphone to which is the next speaker? Is here? Ah, no. Until he's not here, can be continued. But it's planned on the roadmap, develop and continue to work on the leak directory. At the moment, the leak directory is a Wikimedia installation with the collection of the all existing. Are you the next speaker?
No.
Okay.
This is not to be here. So.
Perfect. And at the moment, leakdirectory.org just contain an not updated list of the all whistleblowing sites existing, also corporate whistleblowing and different kind of whistleblowing. You can find in Wikipedia the notable list of GlobalX installations, but in the future, what we aim is that every node, when it's set up, can register himself to a third party and give his own PGP keys. And this can create a sort of directory for a whistleblowing organization in order to avoid this kind of attacks.
Just one question. Does your code base include the crowd, the collaborative features on the end of the processing where you kind of say, hey, okay, well, we have this stuff, but we need to crowdsource the intelligence to analyze the stuff? Did you include that code? Second small question is, it's probably an open problem in server deployments. Is there a way to remotely verify the configuration of the server to ensure a policy exists on the server? And technically, like, this policy is running a deletion policy, for example. Is there a proof that it is 2 weeks and determined to be like 2 weeks and it's all, yeah.
Okay. The first element is a specific context can have a variable amount of receiver. At the moment, the receiver is an user of the node and need to be assigned. In the future, is already planned in the roadmap. You can also integrate external person for a specific tip. So in a specific tip, speaking about a dedicated element, you can know some person skilled in that things and include to analyze on the safe area. Otherwise, the analysis is made out of the platform. For the second question, the GlobalX model, sadly, I've not put here the technical details, but it's based on a Python server that just speaks to the outside with JSON, and a JavaScript client that permits a very good responsiveness, also if the network latency is high because there are Tor in the middle, and also permit to the creation of a mobile application that interact with GlobalX. At the moment we have a beta test of GL Droid for Android and iGlobalX for iPhone and Apple stuff. And On the description of the context, also the retention policies is published, is included. Of course, if some node administrator broke the software and make it communicate fake information and have a different behavior, well, this can be solved. No, but what we are aiming in the future is to provide end-to-end encryption between the whistleblower directed to the journalist using a third party. Therefore, also the node administrator cannot, if there are a rogue node administrator that at the moment is out of the threat model, also a rogue administrator cannot almost interact with the government. At the moment, in example, there are no plain text documents collected in a node if the node is configured well enough to accept only a receiver with PGP. But there are the key on the system, so a rogue node administration can eventually decrypt the documents and keep it for himself. But questions? No more? Some ideas about with the Wisdom initiative? We have already?
I have one, but it's not very typically whistleblowing. It's just very simple. If you do too many hours for your job, you report that daily. So if you're fed up of doing extra hours in your job and not getting paid for that, it's very common in Spain. So just saying I did so many hours today. It's a micro kind of thing. And then at some point, if the company is big enough and enough people are registering their extra hours, or then maybe, not specific to journalists, maybe a worker union or both.
A labor union.
Yeah, and it would not be exactly documents. Your document would be like just saying, you can contact me. I would be willing to go to court if so many people also go, or afterwards do another type of official declaration, but maybe also without being known who is.
I understand, but I have some concern about the fact that whistleblowing is commonly for the public interest. And that is the main difference is also when someone argued that well, but these things has been used by Hitler to collect the tip about the Jew and then send it on the train. And well, that's the difference between collecting information for a public interest or for a private interest. And in our opinion, our ethical suggestion is that if it's a public interest, there are no issue. If there is a private or personal, some issue can arise. In these cases, I can understand the usage, but the fact that there are no some data mean that someone can fake the information that is inserting. Therefore, if it's a problem related to the day job and hours, can be solved in another way. I don't know. Someone that is keeping a separate registry of the day job hours, and after 1 year, it go to the labor union telling, hey, this is our records, we token, and that can be a different kind of problem.
You could actually collect private initiatives, and if they've got the same, if it's the same thing, and it's actually becomes a public interest.
Yeah, because the company is very big, and essentially they can only offer their products so cheap because they cheat on their employees.
Foxconn effect.
Yeah, then it becomes a very public problem again. If it's only private employees and it's the small pizzeria around the corner, well, yeah.
No, indeed, this is also, besides the our accounting, is also a fact of rights of the worker. That need to be respected. At the moment, it does not exist a note about the violation of the on the job, but it's not excused that can exist in the future. And if someone want to create the Foxconn leaking site, will be great. Just I don't know Chinese language, so I don't know which are the step needed. Also, because try to figure out. How can we make a Foxconn leaks? We need to support the Chinese language, and we are using Transifex. Transifex is a collaborative system for translation. Every time we made an update of the platform, we send in English our strings, and other person from other languages start to translate in their language. Then we make the package that is a Debian package, aptitude install global leaks, on a Ubuntu 12.04, because it's a long time support. And then you have the world language. So, by hypothesis, the first thing that is needed is Chinese language. The second thing is someone that knows the Foxconn reality, so know how can be reached the various job operator. In example, after an inquiry performed by the New York Times journalist on Foxconn, speaking with the job, the worker, they know that they will never have an iPhone, so is out of the scope, try to reach those worker with iGlobalX for iPhone. They may just need an interfaces that permit to reach GlobalX, but is in China and Tor is censored. So you need to figure it out some way in order to make it accessible to HTTPS, but avoiding the fact that it can be in some way censored. It's something that need to be just thinked out and find a solution. And then you need to understand which are the violations that you want to expose, because there are different kind of violation. For example, maybe you are not working with a mask with a poisonous gas, and this is something that can be photographed and reported as a proof, because you don't want just that someone write, hey, I was working without a mask because the mask was finished and the one buy the new mask for me. You want that, in fact, there are some kind of real proof. And so you need to figure it out that if you are working without the mask and so you are exposed to poisonous gas, you can create a new context. The context is called poisonous gas. And in this context, you are awaiting almost for one file, and this file probably can be a photo. And then you can make a description about how many times you are working without the mask, and why you are working without the mask, because you need to figure out exactly which are the content that the whistleblower can give to you, and try to focus the whistleblower attention in what can be important for the transparency things. Otherwise, you can just give a page with written an empty form. Tell me your story. Press submit. But this is kind of scale required that there are a lot of crap that need to be analyzed by journalists and then ignored. Instead, for optimize the review process, you need to be focused on specific context.
You just said on a really interesting aspect of the system. So you have a sort of stimulus and response. So the stimulus, zero, is the connection between the whistleblower and the person who wishes to investigate and wants that area. And then you're saying, actually, the investigator provides context or opportunities for the whistleblower to find the aspects which make the story in the end, flesh out the details. And
exactly.
The collaboration synergy is progressing with that. Can you speak more to that?
And another thing that I've not reported in this presentation is the concept of the tip. Because when you create a submission, you have a receipt in back. And this receipt acts like a password for your whistleblower, and this password is valid until the tip is not expired. Until the tip is not expired, you can come back with your receipt, and then upload a new document, explain better what is going on, and read the feedbacks of the journalist. And this kind of collaborative process is the total opposite of the concept that the whistleblowing is only an anonymous Dropbox. Anonymous Dropbox is, I have a secret, I put the secret, I go away, and I never come back. Instead, this kind of cooperation can permit a more efficient exposure of the things and collection of the right data. Another things is was a feedbacks obtained by Pavlix. When they received some important leaks, they have published it. Those information for sure will be read by the person on that environment. So what is also in our roadmap is that when you have something that will be published, you can create a QR code and publish with the news also the QR code or a dedicated URL. And in this URL, you can find a context dedicated on that subject. So everyone that is reading the news is also because know the event, or maybe have some kind of knowledge that can be integrated, and find a dedicated context for speak about that specific element, and this can permit a more exposure of the things.
When a journalist is reading the news, what he's got sent to him, and he's having this dialogue, I guess his computer could be attacked and somebody read the raw data?
Of course, if the computer is compromised, you can be like a ghost on the shoulder of the person. But the suggestion for manage the tip for the journalist is to use TAIS or other kind of live Linux. A live Linux is something that you plug on your computer, turn it off, you open your computer, the operating system is read-only, is executed, it connect to you on Tor network, you are anonymous, then you contact your GlobalX node, you download the documents, and you verify them. If something is contain an exploit, a zero-day exploit, an example in a PDF or a JPEG or whatsoever, and those exploit runs, it compromises your computer, but it cannot compromise your past or your future. So try to mitigate at the best the issue of the zero day that otherwise cannot be mitigated. Another thing that is in our roadmap is called the file sterilizer. So every time a new file is received, instead of encrypted it immediately, is created a virtual machine, is sent on the virtual machine is converted, so a PDF can be converted on a TIFF image, or a JPEG image can be converted in a PNG, and then in a PDF, a doc of Office can be converted in a PDF or in something other. And with this conversion, you are avoiding the fact that some exploit payload can reach the journalist. If the exploit is intended for attacks the conversion system, in this case, the fact that it is in a virtual machine and cannot escape from them, and the life of this virtual machine will be jailed for the execution inside of the box without network control and so on. That is one of the things in the roadmap of the security path. So, thank you.